it's your day to day, how hungry you are day to day, right? Whereas ghrelin, which is released from the stomach, to kind of understand ghrelin, it sounds like growl. It's that, you know, when your stomach starts growling, that means your ghrelin levels are probably high. And ghrelin, when ghrelin is high, unlike leptin, when leptin's high, it does what? Turns off hunger, right? When ghrelin's high, it turns on hunger. Ghrelin is your hour-to-hour hunger warning. Hunger and cravings are different. What's the difference? Hunger is felt in your gut. Cravings are felt in your head. How many of you guys have eaten a meal, you know you're hungry, or you know you're full, right? But you want dessert. You just gotta taste dessert. Gotta have chocolate. I mean, that's a craving, right? So people get that confused because they're like, I don't have cravings. And I don't have cravings. Well, if you're wanting something sweet after dinner, and you've already eaten and you're full, you're not hungry, you're craving. CCK, PYY, let's not get into all these, but I will go into one, these two right here. Gastric, you don't have to know the names, but GIP and GLP. This is gastric inhibitory peptide and glucose-like peptide 1. These are what are known as incretins, and they're really interesting. Because remember what I told you about glucose turns on insulin production? Well, so will these hormones turn on insulin production. But what's really interesting about that is these aren't really released from carbohydrate intake. They're released from fat and protein intake primarily. So here's the idea. Fat and protein also release insulin. Right? Why? Because insulin tells the body we got fuel, we need to store it all away, whether it's amino acids, whether it's fat, whether it's sugar. So here's the interesting thing. If you eat carbohydrate alone, without fat, low-fat muffin, right? You're going to release insulin. If you eat a full-fat muffin or a donut, you're going to release a lot of insulin because now you get this incretin effect as well. That is why you want to be very careful about ever combining fat and sugar. It's the worst combination. It's like pouring gas on fire, right? This is why. Satiation, the feeling of fullness, is most impacted by fiber, fat, and protein. Glucose is not very satiating, right? That's why I can sit down and go through a whole box of Clove Raisin Bran and then start on another one if I want, right? Some of you might be able to as well. I can't eat an 8-egg white omelet because of the protein, right? I can't eat 7 apples because of the fiber. Right? But I can eat 7 bowls. I'm serious. I could probably eat 4. What's the serving size of total raisin bran? A cup? I can eat 4 or 5 cups, no problem. I mean, I remember in college, I had this big bowl, and essentially just poured a whole box in there. Right? Or mac and cheese when I was young. I remember I just could eat all the mac and cheese I wanted. So these are important. They're important because if you can control these, right, then you can control this hunger effect, and you're taking willpower out of the equation a little bit. So the ones to know are just know leptin and ghrelin, and then just know that there's these other ones around that if you do fat and protein, you know, with a bunch of carbohydrate, you're going to get more insulin production. This can work in your favor, right? Post-workout, if you want to build muscle, protein and carb is better than carb alone if you're trying to build muscle, right? So it can work in your favor too, right?